السلام عليكم my dear brothers and sisters. Inshallah, we continue with the last part of Surah Al-Mutaffifin. أعوذ بالله الرحمن الرجيم ومزاجه من تسنيم. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us to compete with each other with regards to doing good deeds and reaching higher levels in Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the drink that al-abrar are drinking. And he continues the description of مزاجهم من تسنيم. تسنيم is a word taken from the same root as the word سنم, which is the camel hump. And the Arabs use that word to refer to something that is the highest level or the highest rank. But the word مزاج means mixture. So like that drink that الأبرار are drinking, because we have two kinds of people here, righteous people, الأبرار and then المقربون. So al-abrar are drinking this amazing drink that is mixed with the drink from tasneem, and tasneem is supposed to be a spring that has this drink for al-muqarrabin. So it's coming from the highest level. So their drinks are mixed from tasneem. But al-muqarrabun, Allah says, عَيْنَ يَشْرَبُ بِهَا al-muqarrabun, that this spring is where al-muqarrabun are located. So the al-abrar are in a lower rank, and their drinks get mixed with a little bit from the tasneem that's coming from where al-muqarrabun live. So al-muqarrabun are getting it pure, but al-abrar are receiving it mixed. And some scholars said that this also refers to the fact that al-abrar are those good people whose good deeds were mixed with bad deeds, and that's why their drink is mixed. But al-muqarrabun are those like the prophets and the shuhada whose good deeds were like almost pure. So that's why they did not have sins at all, like the prophets, right? Or teeny minor sins that were removed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these people, they get the pure drink because of their pure good deeds. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts talking about another kind of evil people. He says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا, those evil people, those wicked, those wrongdoers, كانوا من الذين آمنوا يضحكون. They used to laugh at the believers. وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِهِمْ يَتَغَامَزُونَ. And when the believers pass by them, they wink at each other because they're mocking them. They're looking down upon them because of their arrogance. And then وَإِذَا انقلبوا إِلَى أَهْلِهِمْ انقلبوا فكهين. In addition to laughing at the believers, winking to each other, winking at each other to mock the believers. Also, when they go to their families, وَإِذَا انْقَلَبُوا إِلَى أَهْلِهِمْ انْقَلَبُوا فَكِهِينَ, they go back to their families, those disbelievers, they go back happy because of what they did, proud because of the mocking and the winking that they have been doing. And the scholars said that the reason they are also doing that and talking to their families about it, because they want to make sure that the generation after them, their children, are going to be doing the same things, the same evil things, mocking the believers, making fun of them, laughing at them. وَإِذَا رَأَوْهُمْ, and when they see the believers, قَالُوا إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ لَضَالُّونَ, they say, most certainly, those believers are misguided. So it's one thing if you refuse to follow the messenger, it's one thing if you refuse to believe in him and to be among the believers, but it's another thing when you start attacking the messenger, attacking the believers, and even making the claim that it is they who are misguided. Like the people of Nuh and the people of Hud in Surah Al-A'raf, they say, قَالَ الْمَلَأُ مِنْ قَوْمِهِ إِنَّا لَنَرَاكَ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. They are talking to the messenger, and they say to the messenger, we believe that you are completely misguided. So who are you to say that a messenger who's doing the right things, the good things, who tells you that you should not be cheating people or defrauding people when you're selling to them, right? To say that these are the misguided people, right? And I am the guided one. How arrogant are you? What kind of injustice is this, right? And that's why Allah says, وَمَا أُرْسِلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ حَافِظِينَ. Like, Allah did not send you as a preserver over those believers, as someone who tells what the criteria for good and bad is. So at least if you reject the message, do not go to another extreme and claim that the believers are the ones who are misguided. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, فَالْيَوْمَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنَ الْكُفَّارِ يَضْحَكُونَ. Today, the believers are going to be, meaning on the day of judgment, of course, are going to be laughing at the disbelievers. So in Islam, al-jaza'u min jins al-amal, that your punishment is from the same nature of the deed that you have been doing. You have been laughing at the believers. On the day of judgment, the believers will be laughing at you. عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ يَنْظُرُونَ عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ يَنْظُرُونَ They are sitting on their couches. As we said, this is a symbol of comfort and happiness in Jannah. يَنْظُرُونَ Looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the greatest, as we said, is the greatest blessing of the people of Jannah. And we said about the disbelievers, كَلَّا إِنَّا مَعَ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُبُونَ The worst punishment is that they will be prevented from seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هَلْ ثُوِّبَ الْكُفَّارُ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses thawab. Thawab means reward. When he's talking about the kuffar, it's in a way, this is like when we are being sarcastic with somebody, right? So because they were mocking the believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using the word reward. Did the disbelievers receive the reward they deserve, right? For what they did. Of course, it's not going to be a reward, but it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using this way to show that because you were mocking the believers, you will be mocked on the day of judgment as well. So this surah talks about the defrauders, talks about al-ladhina ajram, talks about two kinds of good doers, al-abrar and al-muqarrabun. And Allah tells us, فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ We should be competing about that. Some of us compete with our neighbors, with our friends over which one has the best car, which one has the best house. But the actual competition should be with regards to ranks in Jannah, because we will see the people in higher ranks in Jannah the same way we see a star in the sky or we see a planet in the sky. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the highest ranks in Jannah. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ الْعَظِيمَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ